Hello. Hello, and welcome to Social Dissonance. This is a durational concert. It happens in Athens and in Kassel in the same time. Today is the last day for the Athens concert. I have to tell you that we are being filmed, and this film is going to be projected here tomorrow and uploaded on YouTube and on archive. Also, that this is a difficult score and we need your participation, and it lasts for an hour. So if you cannot commit to stay for the whole time, it's better for you and for us to leave right now. Otherwise, you can leave in the middle of the concert by giving us some feedback. And you can only use the back door, not the front door anymore. Also, another very important thing is that we have to speak one by one when we want to say something in order for us to be understandable to others because of the acoustics.
So today is the very last day in Athens. The document is happening both at the moment in Athens and in Kassel. And today is the very last day in Athens. We've been trying to connect with Athens in many different ways, and it's very difficult because technology and many different issues. And today, we're going to try to connect with them by trying to be as harmonious as possible. Now, what this means is that I'm going to ask you to come as close as possible to the computer, and we're going to try to make the same tone, everybody together here, and hopefully also in Athens. So we will try to get time to see how it works. So if you could please come closer to the computer, because the microphone is here.
We want to go because it lasts too long.
Okay.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
It's nice, but a little bit too long. A bit too long.
No, it's
cool. Oh, no.
No, it's cool. It's very interesting to talk to the people who are in Athens.
Yeah.
And we're here and to have this connection by this media.
Okay.
Yeah. Thank you.
My thanks to you.
said at the start that
this... I don't know what to refer.
But it's written outside.
Yeah, I don't feel well. I'm sorry, but I would like to do it, okay?
Okay. Give us some feedback so we can learn from you.
I actually enjoyed it a lot. Just joined and made the same noise, and like that kind of like thing didn't happen a lot in my life, so yeah, that was awesome.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Do you have some feedback?
They cannot speak English.
Ah, sorry. Yeah. Would you like to give us some feedback?
Did I understand it right that the people of Athens see us?
Yes.
And we see them?
Yes.
It's great.
Why?
It's great. Yeah, it needs a good imagination to realize that they really see us and we see them, and I think it's a very good project.
Did you find it harmonical? Did you find it harmonical? Was it harmony for you? Was it harmonical?
Yeah, it was communication.
Okay.
It was. They looked what we did and they answered,
mm-hmm.
And we answered. It's great, but I have no time anymore.
Thank you very much.
Thank
Bye.
You.
Yes, it does. Solidarity! We need solidarity! Solidarity! It is not the world!
I think you should go a little further.
Thank you. Have we achieved a collective subject? Have we achieved the collective subject that is in the score? Everybody thinks so?
Think so, yes.
Could you please tell us why?
What is the collective subject?
That's we're trying to work it out.
So we but can't know if we don't know how to define.
If I don't think about it. I don't think it's not in my mind.
In your, but you can feel it. So you feel,
yes.
But you don't think.
But you asked for a collective subject.
Yeah.
I think we've probably established a collective. What's something different than the collective subject?
That's a question that we're trying
I would
to.
Say that.
You will say there is a difference.
There's a huge difference.
Okay. Could you please
subject
tell us?
Subject is something that's a unified thing, and the collective, by definition, is something where like. Different people that are diverse to each other are collected in the same time and space, but they can act differently. They are not forced to act as the same one. So I think there's a huge difference there.
Can you repeat what you said?
Just said this was the voice of the philosopher. But we were also asked to follow instructions, and the instruction was to connect through harmony,
yeah.
Which is already pretty fine about how you connect. And I felt as a sheep following and imitating, I was mimicking. That doesn't mean that you are specifically connecting and mimicking, which is something else. And in that sense, I feel consciously imitating, but in order to connect, you need to have common grounds as well. And here it's just very artificial connection. And I think it's important to disagree. And here it was very difficult to disagree because of the instructions.
Follow those orders that we should. I was asking, yeah, why is it always like someone starts to confront woman or man and people start to follow? But I rather would like to see people disagree, like have a diversity of voices. I was surprised that people would follow that kind of rhythm instead of creating their own. I think it's dangerous.
Yes, but
if that's on paper,
I think it's both. Just dangerous. It can be dangerous, yes, but I think it can be dangerous, but at the same time, it can be a very good feeling if you do things together. And I don't think we just reacted. We reacted on them, but the reaction also is a form of communication. And we always had new ideas, so it wasn't like everybody running after each other all the time. So somebody got a new idea, then people joined in and others did something new. So I think it wasn't that bad. What you said.
In which way do you think it can be dangerous? Because you just agreed that it would be possible that it's... Yeah, and you agreed. You agreed.
Yes, it can be dangerous because if the wrong ideas get people to follow them, then it's dangerous to me. But it's difficult to decide which are the wrong and which are the right ideas. So for me, they might be different than for somebody of IFD, for example.
Did you have a feeling that what happened in this room until now was all right ideas?
No, it was not a matter of ideas, I think. It was a matter of time. No, it was not creativity, it was not family.
It was just happening. This is a safe place, so there's no question about whether it's dangerous or not. There's nothing going to happen.
I didn't feel in danger here. But on the other side, there is someone in Athens who is more radical in his movements, and we choose for certain safety in the imitation of gestures, and we feel like doing this, that we like
well, I mean, this was the most radical imitation of taking the punch away, but that was a figure that it was very dissonant, which we very consciously, most of us choose not to imitate. Yeah, it was like this radical position within, which was like a very isolated, nobody of them was imitating, but we neither did it. So it was like...
we collectively turned our backs.
Why was that?
We were not, somehow we all agreed we were not going to mimic him. I don't know why we did it. That's something that happens. We didn't like what he was doing. We were not laughing about it. Well, first we had a bit with him.
I thought that he was crossing borders. And I turned my back also because I felt like that was a way of communicating to the rest of the group also that I understood that he was crossing a border that maybe shouldn't have been crossed in a group of strangers.
Why?
Because I thought that he was acting quite aggressively and his way of acting physically I found quite offensive. Personally, it's me.
Didn't you think that there was a play that he actually was performing a masculinity that we often see, but it was a performance. Yeah. It was clearly a performance.
Yeah, it was a performance, but still he was performing something that I don't want to give room to.
Even though if it is with that distance that you know there is a kind of... That is part of a performative gesture, that is not the real, not the real...
Like if he shouts at me out of nowhere and I know that he's a performer, still I'm going to be upset by the fact that he shouted at me.
I was rather disturbed because he took a stage for himself, like making us an audience, but he decided to be the actors by coming here. So I was thought like we had that common like the agreement between each other and the people in Athens that we would try to make it. From a collective over that long distance, and then there's someone taking a stage. I thought, that's boring. I don't want to be the audience for that guy. That's why I started to turn my back on.
I wasn't sure if he was one of the audience. Right in the beginning, I just said, what an idiot, something like this. And I wasn't sure that he is acting. So I just thought there's somebody who really has to make himself a little presentable. And after I found out that he was one of the gay, I was like, oh gosh,
He's not.
I don't
know. I think it could. You the same way as I look at her.
Yeah.
Although you have the camera in your hand.
We have, after doing it for more than 100 times, we have like certain characters that appear, like the normalizer, the center of attention, and the revolutionary. And if I have to categorize this person, definitely not the normalizer, maybe the center of attention, but I thought he had revolutionary qualities in the sense that it disturbed the normality of the situation in a way that I personally found that not disrupting or not like crossing borders, but interesting. But maybe you found it very annoying.
It became boring as well after a while.
Yes,
I think the point that we turned our back, we were kind of bored by seeing him doing the same thing all the time, and asking for attention.
But is that more boring that somebody is standing just like?
Good question.
But it was so over the top.
Yeah. But I mean, it's a place where
everything can happen. Yeah.
Yes, but why not over the top here?
I think he stole the room from the others. But nobody was following him either there. His direct community didn't follow him either.
Yeah, he didn't communicate with that.
Maybe because he was too radical. No?
He didn't listen.
He didn't watch.
Then he gave a space. I don't know what happened, so I really don't know. But
I think he acted kind of predictable. Because, I don't know, even 1 minute before I took down his pants, I said to my brother, I bet he's going to put down his pants, and that's what he did. I think it was, to a degree, it was kind of boring.
But we're talking about it. Maybe.
Yeah, actually, yeah. Talking about this. Okay. I think what he addressed, the fact that all of us also acted together, and I felt sometimes like we didn't really try and listen to them, although initially that's what we wanted to, or at least you said we should want to. And then there's some kind of dynamic developed here, which was different than what happened there. And then again is your question, are we mimicking or are we communicating? But I also felt sometimes like we didn't listen.
I think it's part of that machine or the internet or the media. It promises the idea of you can synchronize it and be one, but it's also part of the machine that is not possible because of the internet. It's slow, or I don't know, it shuts down. I think it's a paradox in this thing.
Yeah, I think it's a kind of a border, you know. And after the thing shut down, it was like we immediately found a unique rhythm together as a group. And I think before we just waited on each other to do something we can react on. Mm-hmm. And after that, I think it was the first time that we as a group collectively found a rhythm. I don't know why, but I think it's due to the border of the technique.
That depends on perspective, because you were really in it and you found a rhythm. I was not doing it, and I was totally out of it.
Yeah, it took us 40 minutes to stop mimicking, and I don't know if he was offensive, as you said, but he didn't try to be harmonious. He tried to show up, maybe.
Response as a group and our interaction, for me, was very much conditioned by the instructions when we came here. Because it was about connection that was here, but it was about creating harmony. If you ask me to, if you to remove the harmony away, if you ask me to connect, I think then I would feel more free in how I connect. So I was, this harmony, for me, my interpretation, and this was a collective interpretation because the mimicking was very clear all the time. It was within this harmony, and maybe this is maybe harmony shouldn't be interpreted like this.
It was harmonious. We believe that the outcome was harmonious.
Between both.
The whole.
From time to time.
Yeah, well, even the how do you say, the when it was disrupted, there's some sort of harmony, actually. It's, you do it on both sides, and you, it happened a few times, then you came back again all together. I think the disruption is part of the harmony somehow. It's a dissonant, but it's the same influence as being in accord with each other. It's just a follow-up of a situation, I think. Yeah, it was harmonious.
But for me, harmony is problematic in itself. That's my point already. Like, I think the pretension of being harmonic, it makes a collective group to have one single voice when it's impossible, because my needs, my interests, my... it's completely different of what any of you may want. So I think it's very important to give up this harmony for learning to live with each other, accepting our differences, and allowing them to happen in this arena here.
It was like you said in the beginning, if he asks you to connect with the other it was an instruction to connect with the other group, to be harmonious. But if he would ask you to connect, to make a connection, you would start to talk and find out who they are and what they wanted, what you want, and we try to find common ground. So. Well, maybe by small talking you start to know each other, right? In small talk there are a lot of opinions you put forward, I think.
How are you doing?
Doing fine. Good. I can open my eyes. I'm reacting. This is a response I didn't. I didn't think you would react like this, but my eyes say I'm looking for a way to give an answer. That's you can read that. I think I give a lot of signals.
Silence is happening.